Hello, good friends. How are you feeling today? I believe you're having a good day. My name is Richard, and I want to welcome you to my channel, The Daily Health and Weight Loss. If this is your first time of watching my video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button so that you wouldn't miss any important video. I'll be talking about high blood pressure. I'm going to cover everything you need to know about high blood pressure and how to control it. What is high blood pressure? High blood pressure happens when your blood pressure increases to unhealthy levels. Your blood pressure measurement takes into account how much blood is passing through your blood tubes in the body and the amount of resistance the blood meets while the heart is pumping. Narrow blood vessels from the heart increases resistance. The narrower your blood vessels from the heart are, the higher your blood pressure will be. Over the long term, increased pressure can cause heart issues, including heart disease. High blood pressure is common. In fact, since the guidelines have not changed, it's expected that nearly half of American adults will now be identified with this condition. High blood pressure usually develops over the course of more than 2, but not a lot of years. Usually, you don't experience any signs of sickness. But even without signs of sickness, high blood pressure can cause damage to your blood tubes in the body and organs, especially the brain, heart, eyes, and kidneys. Early detection is important. Regular blood pressure readings can help you and your doctor become aware of any changes. If your blood pressure is high, your doctor may have you check your blood pressure over a few weeks to see if the number still remains higher or falls back to usual levels. Treatment for high blood pressure includes both prescription medicine and healthy lifestyle changes. If the condition isn't treated, it could lead to health issues, including heart attack and stroke. What are the signs of high blood pressure? High blood pressure is generally a silent condition. Many people won't experience any signs of sickness. It may take years or even at least 20 years for the condition to reach levels extreme enough that signs of sickness become obvious. Even then, these signs of sickness may be attributed to other issues. Signs of extreme high blood pressure can include headaches, shortness of breath, nose bleeding, feeling of fainting and almost falling, chest pain, visual changes, blood in the urine. These signs of sickness require immediate medical attention. They don't happen in everyone with high blood pressure, but waiting for a sign of this condition to appear could be deadly. The best way to know if you have high blood pressure is to get regular blood pressure readings. Most doctor's offices take a blood pressure reading at every appointment. If you only visit your doctor yearly, talk to your doctor about your risk for high blood pressure and other readings you may need to help you watch your blood pressure. For example, if you have a family history of heart disease, or have possibilities for developing the condition, your doctor may recommend that you have your blood pressure checked twice a year. This helps you and your doctor stay on top of any possible issues before they become filled with problems. What causes high blood pressure? There are 2 types of high blood pressure. Each type has a different cause. Number 1, first high blood pressure. First high blood pressure is also called extremely important high blood pressure. This kind of high blood pressure develops over time with no identified cause. Most people have this type of high blood pressure. Scientists are still unclear what methods cause blood pressure to slowly increase. A combination of factors may play a role. These factors include A. Genes. Some people are hereditary influenced to high blood pressure. This may be from hormone changes or genes received from your parents. B. Physical changes. If something in your body changes, you may begin experiencing issues throughout your body. High blood pressure may be one of those issues. For example, it's thought that changes in your kidney function due to getting old may upset the body's natural balance of salt and fluid. These changes may cause your body's blood pressure to increase. Number C, surrounding conditions. Over time, unhealthy lifestyle choices like lack of physical activity and poor diet can take their toll on your body. Lifestyle choices can lead to weight problems. Being overweight can increase your risk for high blood pressure. Number two, secondary high blood pressure. Secondary high blood pressure often happens quickly and can become worse than first high blood pressure. More than two, but not a lot of conditions that may cause secondary high blood pressure includes kidney disease, born with heart defects, problems with your thyroid, side effects of medicines, use of illegal drugs, alcohol overuse or long-lasting use, certain endocrine tumors. If your blood pressure is high, your doctor may request you have more readings over the course of a few days or weeks. A high blood pressure result is rarely given after just one reading. Your doctor needs to see events of a sustained problem. That's because your surrounding conditions can add to increased blood pressure, such as the stress you may feel by being at a doctor's office. Also, blood pressure levels change throughout the day. If your blood pressure remains high, your doctor will likely conduct more tests to rule out hidden conditions. These tests can include urine tests, cholesterol examination, and other blood tests. Test of your heart's electrical activity with a recording of the electrical activity of the heart, EKG, sometimes referred to as an ECG. Ultrasound of your heart or kidney. This test can help your doctor identify any secondary issues causing your high blood pressure. They can also look at the effects high blood pressure may have had on your organs. During this time, your doctor may begin treating your high blood pressure. Early treatment may reduce your risk of lasting damage. How to understand high blood pressure readings. Two numbers create a blood pressure reading. Number one, systolic pressure. This is the first or top number. It shows the pressure in your blood vessels from the heart when your heart beats and pumps out blood. Number two, diastolic pressure. This is the second or bottom number. Is the reading of the pressure in your blood vessels from the heart between beats of your heart. Five categories define blood pressure readings for adults. Healthy. A healthy blood pressure reading is less than 120/80 millimeters of mercury. Med higher. The systolic number is between 120 and 129 millimeters of mercury, and the diastolic number is less than 80 millimeters of mercury. Doctors usually don't treat high or higher blood pressure with medicine. Instead, your doctor may encourage lifestyle changes to help lower your numbers. Stage 1 high blood pressure. The systolic number is between 130 and 139 millimeters of mercury, or the diastolic number is between 80 and 89 millimeters of mercury. Stage 2 high blood pressure. The systolic number is 140 millimeters of mercury or higher, or the diastolic number is 90 millimeters of mercury or higher. High blood pressure related serious problem. The systolic number is over 180 millimeters of mercury, or the diastolic number is over 120 millimeters of mercury. Blood pressure in this range needs extremely important medical attention. If any sign of sickness, such as chest pain, headache, shortness of breath, or visual changes happen when blood pressure is this high. Medical care in the emergency room is needed.
Developing a healthy diet. A heart healthy diet is very important for helping to reduce high blood pressure.
It's also important for managing high blood pressure that is under control and reducing the risk of difficulties. These difficulties include heart disease, stroke, and heart attack. A heart healthy diet draws attention to foods that include fruits, vegetables, whole grains, lean proteins like fish.
Increasing physical activity. Reaching a healthy weight should include being more physically active.
In addition to helping you shed pounds, exercise can help reduce stress, lower blood pressure naturally, and strengthen your respiratory system. Aim to get 150 minutes of low-stress physical activity each week.
That's about 30 minutes 5 times per week.
Reaching a healthy weight if you are overweight. Losing weight through a heart-healthy diet and increased physical activity can help lower your blood pressure.
Managing stress. Exercise is a great way to manage stress.
Other activities can also be helpful. These include deep thinking, deep breathing, massage, muscle relaxation, yoga, or tai chi. These are all proven stress-reducing ways of doing things.
Getting enough sleep can also help reduce stress level.
Adopting a cleaner way of living. If you are a smoker, try to quit. The chemicals in tobacco smoke damage the body's tissue and harden blood too in the body wall. If you regularly consume too much alcohol or have an alcohol dependency, ask for help to reduce the amount you drink or stop completely. Alcohol can raise blood pressure.
Dietary recommendations for people with high blood pressure.
One of the easiest ways you can treat high blood pressure and prevent possible difficulties is through your diet. What you eat can go a long way towards reducing or eliminating high blood pressure. Here are some of the most common dietary recommendations for people with high blood pressure.
Eat less meat, more plants. A plant-based diet is an easy way to increase fiber and reduce the amount of sodium and unhealthy saturated and trans fat you take in from dietary food and meat.
Increase the number of fruits, vegetables, leafy greens, and whole grains you are eating. Instead of red meat, choose healthier lean proteins like fish, related to chickens, hen, turkeys, etc., or tofu.
Reduce dietary sodium. People with high blood pressure and those with an increased risk for heart disease may need to keep their daily sodium intake between 1,500 mg and 2,300 mg per day. The best way to reduce sodium is to cook fresh food more often. Avoid eating restaurant food or repackaged food, which are often very high in sodium.
Cut back on sweets. Sugary foods and drinks contain empty calories.
If you want something sweet, try eating fresh fruits or small amounts of dark chocolate that haven't been sweetened as much.
Research suggests regularly eating dark chocolate may reduce blood pressure.
High blood pressure during pregnancy. Women with high blood pressure can deliver healthy babies, though there is a chance of having the condition.
But it can be dangerous to both mother and baby if it's not watched closely and managed during pregnancy.
Women with high blood pressure are more likely to develop difficulties. For example, women with high blood pressure may experience decreased kidney function.
Babies born to mothers with high blood pressure may have a low birth weight or be born before it should.
Some women may develop high blood pressure during their pregnancies.
The condition often reverses itself once the baby is born. Developing high blood pressure during pregnancy may increase your risk for developing high blood pressure later in life. What are the effects of high blood pressure on the body? Because high blood pressure is often a silent condition, it can cause damage to your body for years before signs of sickness become obvious. If high blood pressure isn't treated, you may face serious, even deadly difficulties. Difficulties of high blood pressure include the following. Damaged blood vessels from the heart. Healthy blood vessels from the heart are flexible and strong. Blood flows freely and unobstructed through healthy blood vessels from the heart and tubes in the body. High blood pressure makes blood vessels from the heart tougher, thicker, and less elastic. This damage makes it easier for dietary fats to deposit in your blood vessels from the heart and restrict blood flow. This damage can lead to increased blood pressure and eventually heart attack and stroke. Damaged heart. High blood pressure makes your heart work too hard. The increased pressure in your blood tubes in the body forces your heart muscles to pump more often and with more force than a healthy heart should have to. This may cause an enlarged heart. An enlarged heart increases your risk for the following. Heart failure, abnormal heartbeat, sudden heart-related death, heart attack, damaged brain. Your brain depends on a healthy supply of oxygen-rich blood to work properly. High blood pressure can reduce your brain's supply of blood. Uncontrolled high blood pressure may also affect your memory and ability to learn, recall, speak, and reason. Treating high blood pressure often doesn't erase or reverse the effects of uncontrolled high blood pressure. It does, however, lower the risk for future problems. High blood pressure, tips for prevention. If you have risk factors for high blood pressure, you can take steps now to lower your risk for the condition and ease difficulties. Add healthy foods to your diet. Slowly work your way up to eating more servings of heart-healthy plants. Aim to eat more than 7 servings of fruits and vegetables each day. Then aim to add 1 more serving per day for 2 weeks. After those 2 weeks, aim to add 1 more serving. The goal is to have 10 servings of fruits and vegetables per day. Cut sugar. Try to incorporate fewer sugar sweetening food, including flavored yogurts, cereals, and sodas. Packaged foods hide unnecessary sugar, so be sure to read labels. Set weight loss goals instead of a random goal to lose weight. Talk with your doctor about a healthy weight for you. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, research commends a weight loss goal of 1 to 2 pounds a week. That means starting off eating 500 calories per day than what you usually eat. Then decide on what physical activity you can start in order to reach that goal. If exercising 5 nights a week is too hard to work into your schedule, aim for 1 more night than what you are doing right now. When that fits comfortably into your schedule, add another night. Monitor your blood pressure regularly. The best way to prevent difficulties and avoid problems is to catch the high blood pressure early. You can come into your doctor's office for a blood pressure reading, or your doctor may ask you to buy a blood pressure cuff and take readings at home. Keep a list of your blood pressure readings and take it to your regular doctor appointments. This can help your doctor see any possible problem before the condition advances. I'm sure you are getting quality knowledge about blood pressure. Please, friends, if you are enjoying this video, please drop your comments, like, and please share this video. And if this is your first time of watching my video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button so that you won't miss any important video. 14 different ways to control high blood pressure without medication. By making these 14 ways of life transforms, you can bring down your pulse and lessen your danger of heart illness. Just in case that you have been diagnosed with high blood pressure, you may be stressed over taking medicine to cut your numbers down. Ways of life plays a significant job in curing high blood pressure. On the off chance that you effectively control your pulse with a healthy way of life, you may maintain a strategic distance from, defer, or decrease the requirements for drugs. Here are 12 ways of life transforms you can make to bring down your pulse and hold it down. Number 1. Eat less processed food. The majority of the additional salt in your meal originates from processed meals and meals from restaurants, not your salt shaker at home. Famous high salt items comprises of canned soup, chop meat, chips, pizza, and other processed snacks. Nourishment labeled low fat are typically high in salt and sugar to make up for the loss of fat. Fat is the thing that gives food taste and causes you to feel full. Eliminating, or surprisingly better, removing processed food will assist you with eating less sugar, less salt, and less refined starches. The entirety of this can bring about lower blood pressure. Make it a habit to check labels, as indicated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA. A sodium posting of 5% or less on a food label is viewed as low, while 20% or more is viewed as high. Lose additional pounds and watch your waistline. Blood pressure frequently increments as weight increments. Being overweight likewise can cause upset in breathing while you are getting some sleep, which is a great factor in raising your blood pressure. Weight reduction is one of the best way of life changes you should do if you want to control your blood pressure. Losing even a limited quantity of weight in case you are overweight or fat can help lessen your blood pressure. Basically, you may diminish your blood pressure by around 1 millimeter of mercury, with every kilogram about 2.2 pounds of weight you lose. Other than shedding pounds, you for the most part ought to likewise watch out for your waistline. Carrying a lot of weight around your abdomen can put you at more serious danger of hypertension. Conclusion: men are in danger if their waist size is more than 40 inches, that is 102 centimeters. Ladies are in danger if their waist size is more than 35 inches, that is 89 centimeters. These numbers change among groups. Get some information about a healthy waist size for you. Number 3, stop smoking. Every cigarette you smoke raises your blood pressure for a long time after you finish. Quitting smoking enables your blood pressure come back to typical. Stopping smoking can decrease your danger of heart illness and improve your general well-being. Individuals who quit smoking is likely to live longer than individuals who never quit smoking. Cut back on sugar and refined starches. Numerous logical investigations show that limiting sugar and refined starches can assist you with getting in shape and lower blood pressure. A recent report compared a low-carb diet with a low-fat eating meal. The low-fat meal was comprised of a diet drug. The two diets delivered an excellent result of weight reduction. However, the low-carb diet was significantly more powerful in bringing down blood pressure. The low-carb diet brought down blood pressure by 4.5 millimeter of mercury diastolic and 5.9 millimeter of mercury systolic. The low-fat meal, in addition to the diet drug, brought down pulse by just 0.4 millimeter of mercury diastolic and 1.5 millimeter of mercury systolic. A 2012 investigation of low-carb diet and heart illness found that this diet brought down blood pressure by a normal of 3.10 millimeters of mercury diastolic and 4.81 millimeter of mercury systolic. Another reaction of a low-carb, low-sugar diet is that you feel more full more since you are taking more protein and fat. Number 5, reduce the measure of alcoholic beverage you drink. Liquor can be both good and terrible for your well-being. By drinking liquor just with some restraint, specifically one beverage daily for ladies or two per day for men, you can possibly bring down your blood pressure by around 4 millimeter of mercury. One beverage is equal to 1.5 ounces of 8 proof alcohol, 5 ounces of wine, or 12 ounces of lager beer. In any case, that defensive impact is lost on the off chance that you drink an excessive amount of alcohol. Drinking beyond what moderate measures for alcohol can really raise pulse by many points. It can likewise diminish the adequacy of blood pressure drugs. Number 6, attempt meditation or yoga. Meditation and reflection, including supernatural contemplation, have for some time been utilized and considered as strategies to diminish pressure. A recent report noticed that one college program in Massachusetts has had more than 19,000 individuals practice meditation and reflection to decrease pressure. Yoga, which generally includes posture, breathing control, and meditation methods, can likewise be powerful in decreasing pressure and blood pressure. A 2013 audit on yoga and blood pressure found a normal pulse decrease of 3.62 millimeters of mercury diastolic and 4.17 millimeters of mercury systolic when contrasted with the individuals who didn't exercise. Investigations of yoga practice that included meditation, breath control, and posture were almost twice as successful as yoga practices that excluded one or more of the three of these components. Number 7, exercise frequently. Constant physical action, for example, 150 minutes per week or around 30 minutes most days of the week, can bring down your blood pressure by around 5 to 8 millimeters of mercury in the event that you have blood pressure. It's imperative to be consistent. If you quit working out, your blood pressure can rise once more. In the event that you have raised blood pressure, exercise can assist you with abstaining from creating hypertension. In the event that you, as of now, have hypertension, involving yourself with physical exercises can bring your blood pressure down to more secure level. A few instances of aerobic exercises you may attempt to bring down blood pressure comprises of strolling, running, cycling, swimming, or moving. You can likewise attempt high-intensity intermittent exercise, which includes a changing short eruptions of intense activities action with ensuing recuperation periods of lighter action. Bodybuilding additionally can help diminish blood pressure. Try to involve yourself with bodybuilding in any event 2 days every week. Talk with your primary care physician about building up an activity program. Number 8, reduce caffeine intake. The contribution of caffeine in blood pressure is still not concluded, so it's still open for discussion. Caffeine can raise pulse up to 10 millimeter of mercury in individuals who take it once in a while. Be that as it may, individuals who drink coffee frequently may encounter almost no impact on their blood pressure. However, the effect of the long-term consumption of caffeine on blood pressure is not confirmed yet. It might increase blood pressure slightly. To check whether caffeine affects your blood pressure, examine your pulse inside 30 minutes of drinking a refreshment which contains caffeine. On the off chance that your blood pressure increments by 5 to 10 millimeters of mercury, you might be sensitive to the pulse-raising impact of caffeine. Discuss with your primary care physician about the impact of caffeine on your blood pressure. Number 9, eat a healthy meal. Eating a meal that is wealthy in whole grains, natural products, vegetables, and low-fat dietary items, and with cholesterol and saturated fat, can bring down your blood pressure by up to 11 millimeters of mercury if you have hypertension. This eating plan is known as the dietary approaches to stop high blood pressure dash diet. It is difficult to change your dietary habits. However, with these tips, you can receive a healthy eating habit. Keep a food journal. Recording what you eat, maybe for only 7 days, it will reveal amazing insights into your actual dietary habits. Screen what you eat, how much, when, and why. Think about boosting potassium. Potassium can reduce the impact of sodium on pulse. The best way to get potassium is food, for example, products of the soil as opposed to supplements. Discuss with your doctor about the potassium level that is best for you. Shop smartly. Ensure you take a look at the labels on food when you shop and adhere to your healthy dieting plan when you are feasting out as well. Number 10, lessen your stress. Constant pressure may add to high blood pressure. More examination is expected to decide the impact of constant stress on blood pressure. Infrequent pressure additionally can add to hypertension on the off chance that you respond to stress by eating food that are not healthy, alcohol consumption, or smoking. Carefully consider what makes you feel stressed. For example, relationship, family, sickness, or work. When you recognize what's causing your pressure, consider how you can take out or diminish pressure. In case you can't completely take away all your worries, you can at any rate adapt to them in a more healthier manner. Attempt to change your desires. For instance, plan your day and spotlight on your needs. Abstain from attempting to do excessively and figure out how to say no. You should know that there are few things you can't change or control. However, you can concentrate on how you respond to them. Concentrate on issues you can control and make arrangements to provide solutions. In the event that you are having an issue at work, do your best to talk to your director. If you are having problems with your partner or children, find a way to make peace with everyone at home. Keep away from pressure triggers. Attempt to stay away from triggers when you can. For instance, if heavy traffic while in transit to work causes pressure, have a go at leaving early before the rush hour. Keep away from individuals who cause you stress, if conceivable. Create leisure times and do exercises you love. It's good to always make out time to relax quietly. Try taking deep breaths. Set aside a few minutes for pleasant exercises or leisure activities in your timetable. For example, going for a stroll or cooking. Offering thanks to others can help decrease your pressure. Number 11, diminish sodium in your eating habits. Indeed, even a little decrease in the sodium in your eating habit can improve your heart well-being and lessen blood pressure by around 5 to 6 millimeters of mercury on the off chance that you have hypertension. The impact of taking sodium on blood pressure fluctuates among different kinds of individuals. It is important to limit sodium intake to 2,300 milligrams a day or even less. Notwithstanding, a lower sodium admission, 1,500 mg daily or even less, is perfect for most grown-ups. To diminish sodium in your eating regime, think about these tips. Check the content of food. Do your best to pick low sodium options of the nourishments and drinks you normally purchase. Eat less processed meal. Just a modest quantity of sodium is present naturally in food. Most sodium is included during the processing of the food. Try not to include salt. Only 1 level teaspoon of salt has 2,300 milligrams of sodium. Use spices or herbal alternatives to introduce flavor to your food. If it is difficult for you to radically diminish the sodium in your eating habit abruptly, cut back step by step. Your sense of taste will adjust after some time. Check your blood pressure at home and see your doctor frequently. Home checking can assist you with watching your blood pressure, ensure your way of life changes are working, and alarm you and your primary care physician to potential well-being complications. Blood pressure monitors are accessible generally and easy to get. Discuss with your primary care physician about home checking of blood pressure before you begin. Frequent seeing your doctor is very important in controlling your blood pressure. In the event that your blood pressure is properly controlled, contact your doctor to know how regularly you have to check it. Your primary care physician may propose checking it every day or less regularly. In case you are trying out another drugs or different medicines, your doctor may suggest you check your blood pressure beginning 14 days after treatment changes and 7 days before your next appointment. Number 13, get support. Loved ones and reliable family members can help improve your well-being. They may help you to look after yourself, drive you to the specialist office, or try to exercise with you to help you constantly keep your blood pressure. On the off chance that you discover you need support more than the one you are getting from your loved ones, consider joining a care group. This may place you in contact with individuals who can give you an emotional or spirit lift and who can offer down-to-earth tips to adapt to your condition. Attempt this medicinal herb. Herbal prescriptions have for some time been utilized in numerous societies to treat many kinds of illness. A few herbs have even been appeared to potentially bring down blood pressure. Albeit, more examination is expected to recognize the dosage and the components in the herbs that are generally valuable. Continuously check with your primary care physician or drug specialist before taking herbal enhancement. They may meddle with your doctor's prescribed medicine. Here is an incomplete rundown of plants and herbs that are utilized by societies all through the world to bring down blood pressure. Sesame oil, Sesamum indicum, dark bean, Castanospermum australe, ginger root, celery juice, Apium graveolium, Chinese hawthorn, Crataegus pinnatifida, giant dodder, Cuscuta reflexa, Roselle, Hibiscus sabdariffa, Indian plantago, blonde syphilium, maritime pine bark, Pinus pinaster, river lily, Greenum glaucum, umbrella tree bark, Musanga sephropiodes, cat claw, Oncaria rhynchophila, tomato extract, Lycopersicum esculentum, tea, Camellia sinensis, particularly green tea and oolong tea. 10 tips for using diets to control blood pressure. Fiddling with diet to control cholesterol makes perfect sense. After all, some of the cholesterol that ends up in the blood vessels from the heart starts out in food. Changing your diet to control blood pressure doesn't seem quite so easy. Yet, food can have a direct and sometimes big effect on blood pressure. Fruits, vegetables, low-fat dietary foods, beans, nuts, whole grain carbohydrates, and unsaturated fats also have hurtful effects on blood pressure. There isn't a single magic food in this list. Instead, it is the foundation for a healthful eating success plan that is good for blood pressure and so much more. Difficult, strict, high-quality trials show that eating success plans such as the dietary approaches to stop high blood pressure, DASH diet, DASH versions like the Omni Heart diet, and Mediterranean-type diets lower blood pressure in people with high blood pressure and those headed in that direction. They also help prevent some of the feared results of high blood pressure. Why bother? High blood pressure is the final sneaky silence condition. You will never know you have it without having your blood pressure measured or until high blood pressure begins to damage your heart, lungs, liver, etc. Half of the 65 million American adults with high blood pressure don't have it under control. That's worrisome, given the sneaky and harmful results of high blood pressure. It is the leading cause of stroke in the United States. It adds, gives to thousands of heart attacks. It overworks heart muscles, leading to heart failure. It damages the kidney, wears away sites, interferes with memory, interferes with sexual activity, and steals years of life. Drugs that lower blood pressure tend to work well, but they don't necessarily attack the cause of the problem. And no matter how safe they are, all drugs can have some unwanted or unintended side effects. A heartful diet is an effective first-line defense for preventing high blood pressure. It is an excellent first treatment when blood pressure creeps into the unhealthy zone and a perfect partner for medicines. Unfortunately, translating the dietary success plans tested in scientific fact-finding experiments into diets for daily life hasn't been easy. Here is event-based opinions about diet and blood pressure. Eat more fish, nuts, peas, beans, lentils, etc. Try to burn at least as many calories each day as you take in. Turn to vegetables and fruits instead of sugary or salty snacks and desserts. Select breads, pasta, and other carbohydrate-rich foods that are made from whole grain instead of highly made, more pure white flour. Eat fruits instead of drinking fruit juice. Use unsaturated fats like olive, canola, soybean, peanuts, corn, or safflower oils instead of butter, coconut oil, or palm kernel oil. Depend on fresh or frozen foods instead of canned and processed food. Choose low sodium foods whenever possible. Use herbs, spices, vinegar, and other low sodium flavoring instead of salt. Decrease your amount of food eating if you need to lose weight. If you need help, record everything that you eat day by day for a week. Have this information reviewed by a food and nutrition expert. I'm sure you are getting quality knowledge about blood pressure. Please, if you are enjoying this video, please drop your comments, like and share this video. And if this is your first time of watching my video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button so that you won't miss any important video. 13 foods that are good for high blood pressure. Trying a different diet can fundamentally diminish blood pressure. Studies have demonstrated that specific meals can bring down blood pressure, both immediately and in the long haul. Otherwise called hypertension. Hypertension influences one of every three grown-ups in the United States. Drugs, dietary changes, and other way of life adjustments can decrease hypertension while bringing down the danger of related conditions. Having blood pressure raises an individual's danger of heart illness, kidney cancer, and stroke. We will be talking about foods that can assist with lessening hypertension and give the logical proof. Number one, leafy greens. Potassium enables your kidneys to dispose more sodium through your pee. This thus brings down your blood pressure. Leafy greens, which has proven high in potassium, include turnip greens, collard greens, romaine lettuce, arugula, sweet chard, kale, spinach, and beet greens. Canned vegetables regularly have sodium added to it. Be that as it may, frozen vegetables contain the same number of supplements as fresh vegetables, and they are simpler to store. You can likewise mix these veggies with nut milk and bananas for a sound sweet green juice. Number two, berries. Berries, particularly blueberries, are well in flavonoids, which are natural compounds. One investigation found that taking this compound may check and lower blood pressure. Ripe berries, strawberries, blueberries can be easily added to your eating habits. You can place them on your oats or granola in the beginning hours of the day. You can also take frozen berries as a healthy and quick dessert. Number three, red beets. Beets contains nitric oxide in high quantity, which can help loosen your veins and also lower blood pressure. Specialists likewise found that the nitrates in beetroot juice brought down blood pressure of the people who were used for the research. Some individuals prefer to juice their own beets or just cook and eat the entire root. Beetroot is scrumptious when roasted or added to stews and stir fries. You can likewise heat them into chips. Be cautious when taking care of beets. The juice can recolor your hands and garments. Number four, skim milk and yogurt. Skim milk is low in fat and a fantastic source of calcium. These are both significant components of a healthy diet for bringing down blood pressure. You can likewise choose yogurt in the event that you don't care for milk. As per the American Heart Association, ladies who ate at least 5 servings of yogurt 7 days encountered a 20% decrease in their hazard for developing blood pressure. Attempt joining granola, almond fragments, and organic products into your yogurt for additional health sound advantages. When purchasing yogurt, ensure to check for added sugar. The lower the sugar amount per serving, the better. Number five, cereal. Cereal possesses all the necessary qualities for a high fiber, low fat, and low sodium approach to bring down your pulse. Having cereal for breakfast is an incredible method to fuel up for the afternoon. Overnight oats are a well-known breakfast alternative. To make them, drench half cup of moved oats and half cup of nut milk in a container. In the first part of the day, mix and include berries, granola, and cinnamon to taste. Number six, bananas. Eating nourishments that are wealthy in potassium has advantages than taking supplements. Cut a banana into your grain or oats for a potassium-rich expansion. You can likewise take one along with a boiled egg for a speedy breakfast or snacks. Number seven, salmon, mackerel, and fish with omega-3. Fish are an incredible source of lean protein. Greasy fish like mackerel and salmon are high in omega-3 unsaturated fat, which can bring down blood pressure, diminish aggravation, and lower triglycerides. Notwithstanding, these fish sources trout contains nutrient D. Food once in a while contains nutrient D, and this hormone-like nutrient has properties that can calm down blood pressure. One advantage of preparing fish is that it's not difficult to flavor and cook. To attempt it, place a fillet of salmon in material paper and season with herbs, olive oil, and lemon. Prepare the fish in a preheated stove at 450 degrees Fahrenheit for 12 to 15 minutes. Number 8, seeds. Unsalted seeds contain high quantity of magnesium, potassium, and different minerals known to lessen blood pressure. Take 1/4 cup of pumpkin or squash seeds and sunflower as a nibble between dinners. Number 9, garlic and herbs. One research revealed that garlic can help lessen blood pressure by raising the measure of nitric oxide in the body. Vasodilation is being promoted by nitric oxide, or the opening of arteries, which in turn reduce blood pressure. Adding tasty herbs and flavors into your everyday diet can likewise assist you with curtailing your salt admission. Instances of herbs and flavors you can include incorporate rosemary, thyme, cinnamon, basil, and many more. Number 10, dim chocolate. A recent report found that eating dim chocolate is related with a lower hazard for heart illness. The investigation recommends that as much as 100 grams for each day of dark chocolate might be related with a lower danger of heart illness. Dim chocolate contains in excess of 60% cocoa solids and contains reduced sugar than normal chocolate. You can add dim chocolate to yogurts or eat them with natural products, for example, blueberries, strawberries, or raspberries as a sour treat. Pistachios. Pistachios are great ways to diminish blood pressure by lessening fringe vascular opposition, or vein tightening and pulse. One research found that an eating habit with one serving of pistachios daily lowers blood pressure. You can consolidate pistachios into your eating habit by adding them to pesto sauces, crisps, plates of mixed green, or by taking them straight as a snack. Number 12, olive oil. Olive oil is a good instance of fats that are healthy to the body. It contains polyphenols, which are inflammation battling compounds that can help decrease blood vessels. Olive oil can assist you with meeting your day-by-day servings of fat. It's additionally an extraordinary option in contrast to salads, butter, and canola oil. Number 13, pomegranates. Pomegranates are healthy natural products that can be consumed either as a juice or raw. One investigation inferred that drinking some pomegranate juice once per day for about a month assists lowering pressure. Pomegranate juice is delicious when taken with a healthy breakfast. Ensure to check the sugar content in locally acquired juices, as the additional sugars can refute the medical advantages. Number 14, kiwis. A day-by-day serving of kiwi can diminish circulatory strength in individuals with somewhat raised level. This is the result of one investigation. The analyst looked at the impact of apples and kiwis on individuals with somewhat hypertension. They found that eating 3 kiwis per day for about 2 months brought about a progressive huge decrease in both systolic and diastolic circulatory strength, contrasted with eating 1 apple daily for a similar period. The creators presume that the bioactive substances in kiwis cause the decrease. Kiwis are likewise plentiful in nutrient C, which may altogether improve circulatory strength readings in individuals who expended around 500 milligrams of the nutrient consistently for around 2 months. Kiwis are additionally simple to add to snacks or smoothies. Number 15, watermelon. Watermelon contains an amino corrosive called citrulline, which may assist with overseeing hypertension. Citrulline causes the body to deliver nitric oxide, a gas that loosens up veins and empowers adaptability in supply routes. These impacts help the progression of blood, which can bring down hypertension. In one investigation, grown-ups with stoutness and pre-hypertension or gentle hypertension who took watermelon separate demonstrated diminished circulatory strength in the lower legs and bronchial corridors. The bronchial vein is the primary cause in the upper arm. Scientists have additionally discovered that creatures given an eating regimen wealthy in watermelon would be wise to heart well-being. In one investigation, mice who drank an answer containing watermelon juice had 50% less plaguey in their supply route than the benchmark group. The mice who drank the arrangement additionally had 50% less low-thickness lipoprotein cholesterol, which may depict as terrible cholesterol, and they demonstrated 30% less weight gain than the control creature. To support watermelon admission, add the organic products to plates of mixed green and smoothies or appreciate it in a chilled watermelon soup. Number 16, oats. Oats contain a kind of fiber called beta-glucan, which may decrease blood cholesterol levels. Beta-glucan may likewise bring down circulatory strength as per some examination. A survey of 28 preliminaries presumed the higher utilization of beta-glucan fiber may bring down both systolic and diastolic circulatory strength. Grain additionally contains this fiber. Start the vacation day with a bowl of oats or utilize moved oats rather than breadcrumbs to offer surface to meat or veggie lover burger patties. Lentils. Lentils are a staple of numerous weight control plans far and wide, as they are a phenomenal wellspring of vegan protein and fiber. In 2014, analysts who contemplated the impact of an eating regime wielding in beets on rodents announced diminished degrees of circulatory strength and cholesterol. An aggregate of 30% of the rodents' eating regimen contained heartbeats, including beans, peas, lentils, and chickpeas. Lentils are extremely adaptable. Numerous individuals use them as a veggie lover option to mince hamburger or to add mass to plates of mixed green, stew, and soups. Nourishments to stay away from. While a few nourishments may ease hypertension, others can cause considerable increments in circulatory strength. Individuals can forestall or decrease hypertension by keeping away from the accompanying salt. Sodium can essentially raise circulatory strength. As indicated by the discoveries of a survey from 2013, bringing down salt admission by 4.4 grams day by day considerably diminished systolic and diastolic pulse. Caffeine. The caffeine in espresso, tea, cola, and caffeinated beverages can cause momentary spikes in pulse. A survey of 5 preliminaries found that drinking up to 2 cups of solid espresso can increment both systolic and diastolic pulse for 3 hours after utilization. These discoveries don't recommend that espresso expands circulatory strength or the danger of cardiovascular sickness in the long run. Liquor. Devouring moderate measures of red wine may have some medical advantages. However, bigger measures of liquor can cause emotional increments in circulatory strength. Overwhelming liquor use additionally builds the danger of cardiovascular breakdown, stroke, malignant growth, and hastiness.
Thank you for listening to this
interesting topic about blood pressure. I hope you learned a lot. Please do not forget to like, comment, and share. If this is your first time of watching my video, please subscribe to my channel and check out the other videos in my playlist.